Good evening, good evening. I know this isn't my usual day, but okay, sorry about that, folks. Yeah, I totally wasn't planning on going live. I was actually doing videos, and I had a video option on. That's why you heard the echo. I do apologize. As I said, I had no intention to go live, and sometimes when you're trying to get this out there, things do happen. So again, if that you couldn't hear it, eBay is purging items very obviously. I've been contacted by double digits in just a very short period of time, like 36 hours. Small group of people that have contacted me, double-digit numbers. So at this point, there is some form of purge. Anything that could be construed as anything offensive to anybody, or even stuff that you wouldn't think was offensive, I don't know, maybe you should start calling eBay on every time to see what's safe to list at this point. Between the Vero list and this, I got to wonder. We lost 400 or 500 listings. The majority of them, 99.999%, I wouldn't think would be offensive in the first place. It's more historical items. Some of the items that we've been forced to remove are items, again, that were an African-American business. I had a card from an African-American business. Clearly, no question about it. And eBay told me I couldn't list it. They pulled it down and said if I listed it again, I would be dinged for doing that. Because of the graphics in the card. The card was printed by an African-American company. I don't know what else to say is safe. This isn't offensive. I don't want to insult anybody. It's not my intent, nor has it ever been. I'm a very open-minded person about most anything out there. Everybody has the right to their opinions. But again, if you're going to start shutting down or warning people and threatening them with a 3-day over something as simple as a postcard that shows somebody bowing down, again, this is a service industry position. Somebody was serving tea in one of the cards. A butler, just because he happens to be African-American and he's bowing to serve somebody. When I hear butler again, I hear Alfred from Batman. That's a butler to me. The only other one that comes to mind right off the bat to me from my personal experience would be, what's his name? Tom Green and Bob the Butler. The kids loved that movie when I was a kid. And that to me was a butler. I'm puzzled at some of the items. I'm puzzled at a Joe Louis licensed product. I'm puzzled why that would be pulled down. I wonder what the estate of Joe Louis would think about that, I guess. You know, I know I've grappled with Richard Pryor's estate, but that's not over offensiveness. That was over the fact that they're trying to say I didn't have a license or permission to sell something that already had a license to it. So, you know, again, just be careful with the items that you list. Again, a lot of the items that are brought to my attention, I'm sure after the show I'll probably have dozens and dozens and dozens of more people telling me that this item's been pulled down, that item's been pulled down. Again, if you've had an item pulled down in the last couple days that you're puzzled about or that you had to deal with eBay over, please leave a comment down in the comment section down below this video, because I'd really like to see how widespread or if this is some major issue that everybody's going to have to go over all their items. Two of the people I know have spent hours. They have... One of them I know has like 7,000 or 8,000 postcards alone, not counting all the other tens of thousands of items. Another one has almost 90,000 listings. They've got people going through like as many listings as they can get through as quick as possible. Because if they miss something now at this point, or you miss something, it could be a 3-day suspension from eBay. And if I'm not mistaken, eBay will probably put you in a timeout even after that. Because I don't know anybody who goes on a 3-day suspension that right after they're off suspension has sales come back in. It's like they're dead for a little while. You know, you tell me, but that's what I've personally seen. You know, again, I the people that I talk to, the people that I associate with, we're black, white, mix of any kind. It doesn't matter. The idea that people are going to be penalized for some random item that you would never expect would hold any racial or stereotype or anything else like that it's gotten to be over the edge. Now, I understand certain causes and things like that, but I there's a line that just seems to be keep moving and moving and moving, and I don't know what to do about that with even our own listings at this point. Again, I've been talking about this for quite some time. eBay is like 40% or less of our business at this point. At some point, it's not going to be worth people like me staying on and putting all their efforts into a large chunk of their merchandise going on to eBay. Right this second, part of the reason I'm not, with some of my other videos, I'm not putting out as many and I don't have as many going on, because we're slamming on to Shopify right now. I'm gonna we're done with leaving eBay as our landing pad because of issues that you can't control, things that are totally out of even eBay's policy. We've looked over the policy today along with several other sellers, including a couple of the folks that reached out to me to try and see where the line is on eBay's policy, what the policy actually means, and it's so vague. And that's the problem. Everything is so vague because they're not going to put out any specifics. You can have movies that are fine that use some very derogatory marks towards African Americans, and those movies are okay. And this is one of the subjects that was brought up. And big Hollywood stuff's fine, it seems like. Other things like that are fine to list as well, too, depending on the source of who put out the item is what it seems to be. Big companies don't get in trouble. They don't get smacked on the hands when they do stupid, idiotic, offensive things. But again, it's the little guy like you and I that are going to have to pay the brunt of these and have to invest hours of time trying to determine from an unbiased position on what some one odd person at eBay might deem as bad. Again, I've done this. Anybody out there can do this test probably and call eBay on a couple items, call them on several different days and ask different people what their opinion is of that item. Some are going to tell you better not list it, and some are going to tell you it's okay, depending on the item itself. Again, so there's no solid, this is the policy at eBay. There is nothing. They used to have stuff like that, but every one of the user agreements, all the policy that they have on there is so vague that they could do whatever they want in any situation these days. Nothing is written in stone. And again, this is all goes back to who's running the company right now. Makes all sense with them just trying to get rid of anything that they don't like or to make it a PC site of whatever. I don't know what you want to call it, but it's gotten to be a little bit overhanded and a little bit crazy to now, again, threaten people with 3-day suspensions, or some of them have been suspended over this. So, again, be careful. For me, I'm fine. If they want to suspend us for something that we hadn't a clue on, you know, there's not much you can do, but it just means that it would just push our exit off of eBay as well as many other people's quicker. I know we're doing record sales on eBay, but for that same aspect, I'm doing record sales other places too. It's not just eBay. eBay is 40%, even though it's record sales. I'm doing stuff elsewhere. So, again, eBay lost a large chunk of sellers. eBay's going to lose a large chunk more with the new tax changes because people won't want to pay taxes on items. There's no change in the tax law. There's just a change in how it's reported. Again, there's so many different topics that this borders on with what's going on. The purge is the biggest thing. We're actually, somebody's looking through our listings right now just to make sure there isn't some oddball thing that they may deem is off bounds for whatever reason. Somebody may be bowing too far down to serve, or somebody may be bending over to grab something and they deem that's inappropriate. I know they're a private company. I know they technically can set the rules as what they want, but the problem is that a lot of these, what they're doing and removing, I wouldn't think even violates the rules to begin with. If you're going to lay out the rules and not tell people what the rules are, it's a little hard to follow them. You know, what was it for? I've got screenshots. You can go back to the Wayback Machine on Internet Archive, and you can actually see what some of the pages on eBay, like their user agreement, used to say. They've removed the very descriptive this, that, and the other thing off there and made it so darn vague. I got videos showing that. It's just gotten vague over the years. Anything that they could deem as being a solid line that says this is what you can or can't do is gone almost on there, other than the generalized statements they're doing. I can't even get a straight answer actually emailing personally high up people, including somebody who used to be the head of seller services back at eBay. I asked a policy issue. Just a plain, can you do this? That's all I wanted to know. Nothing that I would deem would be inappropriate to answer. If you're supposedly in charge of seller services and seller support, you would support a seller. Now, I'm not going to call out the name. I probably should, because I've mentioned the gentleman at eBay before. Talked about him with Dom. I've talked about him with quite a few other sellers. The guy I was hoping was a straight shooter, but when you can't answer simple questions on what the policy means, it leaves everybody in limbo. This is, again, the problem on why eBay, even if I'm doing stellar sales and a lot of people are, it doesn't mean eBay is. I'm dying to hear eBay's fourth quarter numbers. If it's down again, it's not going to bode well for eBay. If they're down, if they've lost more, if they sold less revenue but yet made more from fees, from the new pay-per-click promoted, it just means they're going to keep going and adding fee category direction and not worry about anything else. Because if the sales on eBay keep going down because of these types of moves, eBay will be number four not too long from now. You've got, McCary, however it's pronounced. They're going after vintage and all sorts of things right now. I hear TV commercials, radio commercials. Everybody's telling me they're all over. I heard one on the internet even. So I love the platform eBay itself, but the management, oh my gosh. They've went off the deep end, in my opinion. And this isn't a political issue either. I just want to stress that I'm not a political person. I honestly am not. I'm not a member of any party. I'll just tell you that. I've been a member of both parties. So I'm not a member. I'm basically being independent across the board. And the political party means nothing to me. It's a stake on doing the right thing towards the people selling the platforms. You give them an idea on what is right and what is wrong and go from there. You can't just be so vague. Back from Burger King. Yep, I'm McCary. I don't care. I guess that's the point. I haven't even cared what the pronunciation is. There's certain things that I like. Backdraft. I don't give a hoot what the movie's about. I don't care. There's certain things I just don't care. This is not a Vero issue either. I see Barlight Broker. It's not a Vero issue. This is a I don't know, offending people issue, I guess, is what eBay's trying to say. Again, I've looked at the items that were removed for most of them. I can't see all of them. One of them doesn't have a couple of them don't have images anymore because they don't save them. And when eBay yanks your listing, the listing's gone. You can't see it. It doesn't show up and ended. Several of the items that were taken down by the folks that contacted me, there's sold records of, and there's also other ones up of those same cards right now, or the book or the sheet music or the bank in general. So we all know that, you know, you might get dinged and there might be 100 other people selling the exact same thing that you got dinged for. You could even point them out to eBay and they'll still be up a week from then. It happens all the time. So it's just a waste of time like that. I've reported someone who was actually full-fledged ripping off eBay the way they were doing the multi-item listings. They had like 20 different items in one listing to save the fees. None of them were related in any way, shape, or form. Different brands, different manufacturers. They were doing with clothing and all these sorts of things. eBay doesn't care. You know, they'll care about certain specific issues here. So again, if you've got anything new, old, a t-shirt that has some logo on it, the General Lee, you better take down, is my guess from what the comments were made to. Anything with the General Lee from the Dukes of Hazzard. Again, I grew up on the Dukes of Hazzard. I never once related it. Born and raised in Ohio. I never once related it to anything personally racial. I know there are some folks who see that as that way, and I can understand their point. But for me as a child, it was just a show of somebody who moonshined and hated the law because they were overhanded. That was it for me. So again, I actually met John Schneider once at Disney and stuff. So you're going to have to take and pick on what's safe and what's not, but we're not taking any chances at this point anymore, at least for the time being. Be safe, be practical, list them somewhere else. It was my only guess. There are other places to list it. Facebook, I guess, would be a good alternative for many items. As long as it's not offensive in general and its scheme. I'm sorry, 1980 Dukes of Hazzard action figure is not offensive in my opinion. I've got some here in-house right now. It's a toy that I never could have afforded and my parents wouldn't have bought me back then. So still has fond memories. I grew up on those types of things. What's next? I mean, Hogan's Heroes could be deemed because they show German officers and stuff and they show the emblems in there. It's negative towards Germany, very obviously. But again, where are we going to draw the line? I'm not trying to create any controversy, but I've got quite a few people who are worried to death that they're going to miss something in their store and get shut down on eBay over something they would have never assumed was a problem in the first place. So, again, take it as you wish. I don't know where this leaves most people who sell vintage or collectibles with a lot of the stuff that you sell. You're going to run into things that may not be racially correct or proper in the first place, buying anything vintage anywhere. You know, it's what you do. Obviously, don't list them. If they're offensive, obviously don't list them. I would never, ever, ever recommend or suggest anybody do otherwise. It's just not, I never did that. I've never done that. You know, and I know some folks are going to bring up the issue of, say, Hitler or German items in general. You can sell coins with Hitler on them. You can sell stamps with Hitler on them and things like that, because those are considered history, but a photo may not be considered history. Time magazine cover with Hitler on the cover may not be history. Again, I'm not defending anybody like that. Trust me, it was an atrocity and the whole works. I'm not defending anything, but they allow certain things and certain things they don't. Again, it's not our site. We don't have any authority. We don't have any way. Hang on, I'm sorry. Let me see back to the feed because I see a lot of comments going on here. In fact, my feed is way, way, way full. Yeah, again, I'm not saying offensive things should be listed at all. Don't get me wrong. I'm not using it to. Yeah, I'm just reading through the comments. Holding people's funds. Yeah, I talked to Kat, the nurse flipper, the other day, and I know she had some issues with that. Again, this isn't a political issue. eBay is not a political entity at all. So, I mean, I don't. It's sad that we get it turned to a political issue. It has no bearing on who's running the country, not running the country, who did run the country, who didn't run the country. I don't think in all of the 4 years I've been on YouTube here, I've ever discussed anything political. I'm not a political person, trust me. I'm a business person. You know, I live in a capital country, or capitalistic country, to the most extent. I take advantage of whatever, not take advantage, don't take it that way, but I use the structure to make money, to sell items, and to run my business. It's a business. So I do draw lines on offensive stuff and things like that. I don't buy them. I don't mess with them. I don't buy them. I don't want to offend somebody. I don't want to lose a buyer or customer because I have something in my store that would be offensive to them. It makes no sense to intentionally list something or to put something out there that would be offensive. Cultural ones seem to be the easiest to make a mistake on, because from my personal experience with Japanese in general, I'd love to go to Japan. I mean, I've got some nice Japanese collectibles here, but you bow. I bow if I go and somebody bows to me in a Japanese restaurant. So if a postcard showing someone serving tea in a tea house and bowing as they do it, you've got to bend down to serve tea. I mean, that's just like the bare bones basics, that it's a cultural thing. It's you bow. It's polite. You know, the Matrix, they bow. So should we kill the Matrix or what? I mean, again, I'm not trying to be controversial or cause some big stink with people, but the end of the story is anything could be offensive to somebody. There's a South Park episode. They're talking about Christmas. I think it was a what would or wouldn't be offensive, and it just went off the chain, and that's what it's kind of reminded me of a little bit. Again, a book written by an African-American artist should be banned on eBay. a white author writing a book disparaging white authors or something, is that offensive? I mean, I don't know. I don't know where the line is drawn, but you can't rely on specifically eBay, for example. Again, this just follows the route of them removing the adult category in my book. It's all a purge on the platform is what I see it as. Coins taken down and stuff. Part of the reason coins are an issue because there's a lot of forgeries. There's a lot of counterfeits that flood in from other countries into this country. It's a fact. I've seen them. I've been to folks who have bought them personally. I've been there when they've drilled them to see if they were real solid silver, and a large chunk of what's on eBay is fake. That's still up there. You know, coins was one of those. eBay makes too much money. And adult entertainment falls in line with certain categories of vintage collectibles that you have to wonder and worry about. Whether they are offensive or showing fish on them, for all I know, you know, it's just another example. Everybody can be offended by, or anybody can be offended by something. You know, it doesn't mean that you may see it as offensive or someone else does. I mean, Again, I don't want to just ramble on about this, but we're looking over our inventory. I would honestly recommend everybody looking over their inventory. I don't care if you sell shirts, hats, or anything else like that. If there's any way that somebody could deem it inappropriate, I would be worried. This is the first time in 3+ years of running Patreon that I've ever had somebody bring up an issue like that, more than one person. And this time it's 4 people. And then I reach out and it turns out there's, you know, dozens of people that are having similar issues about similar type items. Maybe it's new folks getting in, but I don't see that because these are folks that I've talked to for quite a few years. Again, I'm not going to mention any names because I didn't ask for permission to do so, but I've got emails, I've got screenshots, and I've actually been played a conversation from eBay, from a phone conversation that was recorded by somebody else. You know, so anything, colonialism was the one that really got me. Because, well, I guess you could say Japanese had some form of it, but U.S. was founded on colonialism, and it's a U.S. company, and so what is George Washington now inappropriate? I mean, again, that's jumping at straws, I'm sure, but it's just the factor here that the items I saw were items that were licensed or in cases written by an African American, and you're going to say that that's offensive to... Again, one was a cookbook, for crying out loud, showing how to cook things that, you know, my wife's got a cookbook, and it's an African-American author, and it's crawfish etouffee and stuff like that. I mean, that's I love that stuff, and it would be offensive maybe to somebody because of some of the terms in there. I mean, I don't know. I think it's gone over the edge to some extent, a lot of the stuff like this, because it's penalizing people for things that you may not be aware that would be... anyway, let's just see who's in-house here. Before I forget, too, tomorrow I have a live show here. Tomorrow, the normal live show, but I've got a bunch of other resellers are going to be on. We're having a full-fledged... brainstorming session. It's going to be a round table. We're going to be discussing issues. I'm going to be throwing out a bunch of topics to everybody. There are going to be topics to help everybody with sales, keeping yourself safe, policies or practices that will help you from their sides and their views as well. It's going to be some quick sessions where we go around the room and we're going to be asking the same question to each one. We'll get you some general consensus. These are people that I've discussed and went back and forth with for quite some time, years in some cases. So you're going to get to see some other folks here tomorrow evening at 7. Hopefully it'll be a great show. I really hope so. It's my first one with a bunch of other people on the show. And if it works out well and people get a lot of content and good stuff from that, we'll go forward with more of them. But just again, tomorrow's live show will be something special. Some of them, like Annie's in house now, I think maybe Marty was. You'll get to see and meet some other folks that... Some of them have channels, too, like Annie. Annie does have a channel. I've watched some of her videos as well, too. So, anyway, that's tomorrow's show. Safety is the biggest concern here, though, as of today. Again, I do have another video I plan on putting up, but I won't put it up today. You'll see that Friday, just because I think this was too important. Again, I'm not saying eBay is technically doing anything wrong. It's their company. They can pull down or do anything they want with the listings. It's always been that way. But to start threatening and making what I would call threat next time it happens, you're gone for 3 days, is a threat. The first person who pointed that out, to them they were shocked. Couldn't even imagine why someone bowing or why a cookbook would be considered bad. I don't get it either, but that's the policy. That's the world we're living in now. If you want to still sell on eBay, you got to follow what they say. Again, that's just the way it is. It doesn't mean you're being weak. It doesn't mean you're doing anything like that. But if you want the privilege to use the services of eBay, you got to follow and go along with what they say. That's just how it is anywhere you work. If you're working for somebody else, there's a lot of things you can't do. eBay, there's quite a few that you can't do, but nowhere near as many as you would if you were working for somebody else. It's not the end of the world. It's not let's screw over eBay, but... Some of these obviously are very poor decisions based on someone who may or may not even be in this country who doesn't understand cultural or anything else like that. So anyway, take it as you will. Be safe. Look over your items. Don't list stupid things. Don't list things that were obviously and clearly offensive. even modern day stuff that they're printing. There's a ton of stickers right now that could be on that list too. A ton of stickers and a ton of things that I've seen pointed out to me. Derogatory remarks, even if they're veiled in other words. Again, this is what's going to have to be looked out for by you as a seller going forward. This is the second purge that I'm aware of. Just because it didn't hit you yet or you haven't been taken down, maybe you don't have anything offensive. Or maybe they just haven't gotten around to it. I don't know how they're doing it. Something's going on. There's no way that this many people in just a short period of time had it happen unless it's a concerted effort. And from the conversations that was shared with me, it does appear like eBay has some lines drawn with very specifics being stated. You know, they went over a whole list of things. So there are some things that are definitely, if you list it and has that in it, or like a monument or a battle flag. And it didn't just say battle flags of, say, Confederacy or anything. It just said battle flags was the comment. Didn't say specific. So war relic sellers, which I am one, you know, you got to wonder, you got to worry a little bit. So again, I'll leave it at that. Take it for heart. Be careful. Don't do anything stupid. I'll say it one more time. Far too many people don't pay any attention or just think it's a quick buck, and I'm not going to worry about what I list. I'm very cautious, very careful in everything we list. I pull it. We constantly pull stuff for whatever reason. Sometimes it's because of quality. Sometimes there's a rip we missed. Sometimes something slipped through that may be determinative to be offensive to somebody. So again, I'll leave it at that. I thank everybody for coming on. If you enjoyed the conversation, please hit that thumbs up. Just be cautious. Again, if you had it happen to you, please leave a comment down in the comment section down below. I'd really love to see if this is huge, widespread, or it's just hitting small groups of people at the same time. But we will end it off on that, and I hope you all have a good day.